Jesus arrived on earth, defying nature, defying what people consider to be natural, defying what was reality. I mean, he arrived supernaturally, supernaturally. He was born of a virgin. And all of his life, all of his ministry, when he started doing ministry, he did things that existed on the outside of the natural. People expected him to abide by the rules that they assumed were the rules. And he did what he did. He did his own thing. He abided by what God had called him to do. He abided by those rules. And in abiding by those, he gathered a group of people together that others would have considered not capable, unable to be together. I mean, he brought a prostitute into a place of following him. He brought a tax collector. He brought a fisherman. He brought all these different people from all different regions and all different places and all different experiences and all different expressions in life. And he brought them together and he created this ministry group. He created this powerful, impacting, unchangeable, solid. Yeah. It took some failure. All right. I mean, at the cross, they scattered, they ran away. After the resurrection, though, he brought them together again, and he reminded them of his love and his affection. He gave them his spirit, and then they were released on the world, and they just radically changed everything. I mean, just to prove even farther that he grabbed those that were completely out of the realm of what they would understand, is he grabbed Saul, and who became Paul, and Paul became, I mean, just an incredible ministry leader to the Gentiles. The Gentiles were those who were considered less than or worthless by the Jewish nation. And Jesus brought people together. And he didn't expect uniformity. He expected that people in all of their different experiences, all of their different, all their differences, if you will. He brought them all together, and they were capable of doing a ministry that was just, it changed the world. What am I getting at? All right. There are unique things that make us different. There are unique things that make us all in all different walks, all different places, all different skin tones, all different nationalities, all different. We are all different, man and woman. We are all different. We are all different. And God, in his power through his son, Jesus Christ, is able to bring all of us together, not in a sense of uniformity, but in unity. Unity, the epitome of unity is people in all different walks of life, in all different places, being able to come together and accomplish the will of God, to be able to accomplish the work of Christ, be able to accomplish something so impossible. If we were all the same, shoot, how boring life would be if we all looked the same. How boring life would be if we were all the same color. Come on, let's be real. How boring would life be if we were all the same size? How boring would life be if we all had the same hair color, the same eye color? How boring would life be? How boring would life be? Why? Why did God create all of this? Because he is just so full of imagination. And I mean, the intricacies of his creation just blow my mind. And when you begin to look at the specificity of our fingerprints, you should stand in awe of his work. And so, like, in our personalities, in our laughter, in our strengths and our weaknesses, and all the different things that make us who we are, the epitome of unity is God bringing through his son, Jesus, bringing all those people groups, all different nationalities, all different people together to accomplish his will. We are at a difficult place, guys. We are wrecked. And we need to begin to turn to Jesus and understand that this man has come to bring unity in all different people and begin to move forward. Man, begin to move forward. God wants to do so much in your life. He wants to do so much through you. He wants us to experience the beauty and wonder, the mosaic of his love, and how the beautiful mosaic of all different people begin to radiantly, brilliantly light